thoughts out of myself. Especially the old Irish. The old Irish love songs. Marvelous. Romantic, wild stuff. The very first night that I rolled in beside her, her bones were as sharp as the teeth of a saw. And her skin was as cold as a frog on a mountain. Not a sound tooth in her hole on her jaw. Tommy writes some beautiful love songs. He writes them almost as if he knew something about it.
I hear you laughing.
Him and know nothing about it.
I'm learning. There's another very unlikely poet. Okay, I was going to say he was a friend of ours in Dublin, but he wasn't a friend of anybody, as far as I know. Patrick Kavanagh. I know when he's in his old age, when he used to sit in the corner of O'Neill's pub in Dublin, Mary the Row, and growl at all the young literary types who would gather around him. He'd allow them to buy him drinks, that was his father. But he wrote some marvellous love poetry. You wouldn't think he was capable of it either. He wrote this one for a... I can't remember exactly what her name was. I know she was married to another man, and she broke his heart. He wrote this poem for her called Raglan. Raglan Road on an autumn day I saw her first, and knew that her dark hair would weave a snare that I might one day rue. I saw the danger, yet I walked along the enchanted way, and I said, let grief be a fallen leaf at the dawning of the day. On Grafton Street in November, I tripped lightly along the ledge of the deep ravine where can be seen the warp of passion's pledge. The Queen of Hearts is still baking tarts and I not making hay. Oh, I loved too much. By such is happiness thrown away. I gave her gifts of the mind. I gave her the sacred sign that's known to the artists who have known the true gods of sound. Stone and word and tint. I did not stint. I gave her poems to say, with her own name there, and her own dark hair like clouds over fields and gray. Her quiet street where old ghosts meet. I see her walking now away from me, so hurriedly. My reason must allow that I have wooed not as I should this creature made of clay. When the angel woos the clay, he blooms his wings in the dawn of day.
Fair and lovely Annie, your gentle ways upon me. You bring peace and joy and laughter everywhere. Where you go, the sunshine falls. Your breath is sweet and pure, and my heart and soul are always in your care. Gentle Annie. Like the morning dew before the rising sun, when your eyes tell me you love me, then my soul is filled with wonder, and my love for you will live when life is done.
I will still have gentle love.